Okay, this is part two, and I'll give you this is a larger sheet of mixed media paper. But you're gonna fold it the same way that you fold your Bristol. And that just helps you be able to fold it more easily. And we're going to be choosing analogous liquid watercolor. So this is something that you'll have in the classroom. And I am using yellow orange and just a plain orange. So analogous means that they are similar in that they share a common hue. They're colors that are found next to each other on a basic color wheel. And some of these just have a little piece of styrofoam. Okay, I'm just gonna drop straight out of the bottle. In class, we might use droppers. So I'm just shaking some out there. You'll see the liquid watercolor is really vibrant and it goes a long way. It's really thick. And you have a little bit more paper to work with, so you can use a bit more. You can experiment and see. But it is liquid, so it's going to squish out. That's why we've got paper underneath here to catch it. So analogous colors harmonize. In the places where you see that they're mixing, they're going to create a new color. But that color is all within the same kind of range of the warm red to yellow spectrum. And of course, where the red and the yellow orange that has a little bit of red in it is going to make a more intense or a redder, more red kind of orange. So you're going to make several of these following the same process as your your black ink blots. And I'm just going to move the camera slightly so that you can see the whole thing. Looks kind of like a flower. Okay?